Hello everyone, XM Starship here. Well, today I'm going to be doing a video on a package I got from Bosnian Bill. Now this was a surprise package I got from him right after I got a package from JM Murdy. Sorry about not doing an out-of-the-box opening on video, but I had one, but it got lost in the upload and I ended up deleting it somehow, so... But I am going to do this video. I'm going to open a couple of them. He sent me some really nice locks here. He sent me this American Series 7260. I don't yet have a tubular pick, but there's something interesting about this lock. The last package he sent me had one of these, and this key, they're actually keyed the same. This key will open that one as well. So I got two key-to-like American padlocks. He'd also sent me this bird watcher. Now this is actually a pretty cool lock. I like this. It's a dimple lock. 450/50. German engineering. Here's a look at the key bidding for that. It's actually a pretty cool lock. Does work. Operates very smoothly. He also sent me this really nice Avis 8550. I have a key for that here. Here's what the bidding looks like on that. I have picked it a couple of times, but it takes me a little while. I'm going to wait and do a video on it when I get music wire. He also sent me this really cool Euro cylinder from Avis. It's a little four-penner. This is actually a great training lock. It's not that hard to pick, but it has very crisp sets in it. Very good feedback. I'm going to pick that. He also sent me two Americans. These are keyed the same. Well, I guess they're keyed the same. I don't know. I don't have keys for them. But they're Series 10. Now I've seen his video on these about how to rebuild them, and I'm actually going to get American cores. Jeff Moss is sending me some screws and security nuts. Now when I get the cores, I am going to try to drill one out and replace it on video and make functioning locks out of them. I have picked them, and I'm going to pick a couple of them. I think I'm going to start with this one. I'm going to get this. I want to do a video on this bird watcher. Now, I don't have dimple picks, but with these kind of keyways, I found a way to pick them with standard tools. What you do is you take your standard tension wrench and you put it in between the teeth here, the keyway. So it pushes up on one and pulls down, and it kind of locks itself in there. And you can tension the key that way, the keyway. And you take your short hook and you run it down the side of one of the teeth, and that gives you something to pry off of, and you can hit the pins at an angle. I'm going to do that right now. I can keep it in focus here. You can feel the feedback. All you do is just ride it right in between those wardings. The hook is too wide to go straight from the top, so you get at them at an angle. I have an Avis EC75, a small one, but it has the same type of keyway, and I pick that the same way. And there it is. Let me go ahead and pick this one. I don't have my vise with me, but I can still pick it. I like picking cylinders in the vise because it represents in the field picking. You know, if you're in the field, you're not going to be able to hold the cylinder in your hand and position it whatever way. But like I said, this gives very crisp feedback. And for this, with the small keyway, I'm going to be using my offset diamond slimline pick. tell exactly what's going on in here. See, this is a very good practice lock. There it is. See, you can hear the sets real clearly on it. It's a very nice lock. Thank you very much, Bill. I think I'm going to pick one of these Americans now. Like I said, I have no key with these. They are the Series 10. And I'm going to do the traditional top of the keyway tension, Peterson pry bar. Use a standard hook. Let me back up a little bit here. Move in. Like I said, when I drill these and rivets and try to replace the cylinders, I'm going to try to get it on video. So sorry about not keeping updated on the videos and that. I've just been very busy lately, you know, work and everything else. But I am going to be catching up on watching my videos. And Jeff Moss and J.M. Murdy, your packages are going out within the next day or so. And Bill, I got something I'm sending you too for these. Okay, there's my false set. I'm willing to say that these are probably bitted very erratically, because they're actually kind of hard to pick for Americans. I've had a lot of experience picking Americans. These and Abus are fastly becoming my favorite locks. There we go. You can see vaguely the rivet down inside there. All right, Bill, thank you very much for the locks. I'm definitely going to get something out to you. I've made a decision on one of the locks I'm going to send to you. You'll probably be surprised to see it, but it's going to be on its way to you shortly. All right, everyone, thank you for watching.